Throughout time, groups of women have organized across the planet to win enormous battles, to lead movements, to create positive change in spite of overwhelming obstacles and in the face of growing despair. We honor these women in the spirit of cariño.
From 1950 to the year 2000, Kenya lost 90% of its forests. Wangari Maathai, born in 1940 in the provincial capital in Nyeri, she founded the Green Belt Movement. And over a period of 30 years, she mobilized women to plant 30 million trees. We honor the memory of Wangari, priestess of cariño, her work, her victory.
Please, no more deep breaths. No more calming breaths, compassionate breaths, solidarity breaths. No more getting ready to confront breaths, de-stressing breaths, clarity of thought breaths, preparing to exert or hitting a high note and getting exasperated breaths. Not even the spiritual breaths. Yoga, nasal breaths, good, bad, shallow breaths, belly breaths, back breaths, even giving birth breaths. I want no more breathing advice. I will take no more deep breaths. I hereby refuse to take anyone else's air. Well, first of all, it's toxic. And who wants a lung full of air you can practically see? It's so foul. Second of all, I don't buy from the take a deep breath peddlers selling greed in the guise of good health. Anyone with half a brain can see the air is everywhere. No need to take it like it were some commodity about to run out. Maybe that's the problem. We are all gasping for air, on a steady diet of shortness of breath. We are a society of anxiety, in the tradition of, I don't have enough air, so quick, let me have yours. And the civilization of, we've already mined the oxygen out of this stuff, so let's use theirs. Isn't it just like us? So not knowing that we sit in eternity all the time, while we grasp for it in all the unperceived actions of our own bodies, the unperceived actions of our thoughts, our hearts, our hands. Stop breathing and be breathed.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Anne, and I'm an addict.
Welcome. Hi, Anne.
I'm addicted to doing. No sooner do I make an effort than I need another. I exert more effort with every breath, and not feeling it anymore, I crave more doing in an effort to experience my own doing. I am a culture addicted to doing. Pumping up, shutting down, building up, pushing down, bulking up, numbing down. I need another hit of abdominal crunch. I require a fix of lactic burn. I yearn for the strain of muscle pain. It makes me feel like I'm doing something. The more I do, the less I feel. The less I do, the more I feel. The less I do, the more I feel. The less I do, the more I feel. I want to be undone. are the bees of the invisible. We wildly collect the honey of the visible to store it in the great golden hives of the invisible. Colony collapse disorder. When I heard it on the radio one day, I thought it was a joke. Then I learned that colony collapse disorder refers to the fact that our honeybee population is being decimated, and with them goes the future of our food supply. What happens to them is unknown. The adults are simply gone, thousands of them. No corpses left behind, nothing out of place. They are just gone, visible, invisible. Experts say it could be mites, pesticides, black beetles, GMO crops, high fructose corn syrup, travel in flatbed trucks, overwork, noise pollution, cellular phones, immune system disorder, or wild weather patterns. But I prefer to think they simply jumped ship, flew the coop, took the high road, moved on to greener pastures or cleaner planets, or evolved into higher life forms where beings understand the meaning of caring capacity. Last night, I dreamed I had a beehive here inside my heart, and the golden bees were making white combs and sweet honey from my old failures.
Globally, Coca-Cola extracts up to 1 million liters of fresh water per day, turning two-thirds of it into wastewater. Under the leadership of my Lama of the Eravalar tribe in Kerala, southern India, where the Coca-Cola's operations render their drinking water unfit for human consumption, the community of Plachimada mobilized and effectively shut the bottling plant down in March of 2004. To this day, that plant remains closed. We honor my Lama, priestess of Cariño, her work, her victory. Thank you.
Some bowls are cool to the touch. Some bowls are full of stew. Some bowls don't hold too much. What kind of bowl are you? Though made of porcelain, some bowls last tens of centuries. Though made of solid gold, some bowls change in a flash meltdown. Some bowls age in penitentiaries. Some begging bowls sit out on the ground. Some bowls sing. Some bowls get passed around for everyone to drink. Some bowls get smashed in the kitchen sink. Some bowls stand still in the old bowl museum. Some bowls go to every potluck. Some bowls overflow. Some bowls suck it up. Some bowls clutch ash in the mausoleum. Some bowls hold hospital suffering. Circling bowls alleviate envy. Water bowls consecrate nativity. Burning bowls emulate eternity. Flower bowls recreate proclivity. Red garuti bowls soak up, soak up, soak up negativity. Some bowls spill out in offering. Some bowls transform. Some bowls bring about a sea storm. Some bowls say bowls witness everything. She loves all bowls she makes. All bowls break. All bowls return to her. The mother of all bowls. Dishes up love. That's why the love is unconditional. Unconditional love belongs to bowls.